In the LibreOffice Draw work area, we can see the page we have to work with, and the margins are clearly shown on the page. My page size is set up as a standard US letter 8.5 by 11. If I want to change that, I would go into Format, Page, and I can change it right here. The largest page size allowed is about 118 inches or 300 centimeters. For someone who has a large printer plotter, that would work well. I only have the standard 8.5 by 11 inch printer, so I'm going to stick with that size paper. But I am going to change my margins to a quarter inch. This dialog box would also be the place to choose my page orientation of portrait or landscape. I'm going to stick with portrait. Looking at our right side of our page, it looks like our page width is only 8.25 inches. But actually, the work area, the area inside the margins, is 8 inches wide. With a half inch on the right and a half inch on the left, making up the 8.5 inches. The same goes for the length. We can change the unit of measurement on the rulers by right-clicking on them. I currently have inches. I can change this to centimeters. The horizontal and the vertical rulers are independent, so I can have an inches on one of them and centimeters on the other. I'm going to leave them both inches because that's what my default unit of measure is. To change the default unit of measure, we would go into Tools, Options, LibreOffice Draw, General, and under the settings, we have unit of measure set for inch. If I wanted to change it to centimeters or millimeters, I would do that right here. But I'm going to leave this at inch and cancel out. Now let's take a look at the status bar, specifically these numbers right here. What these numbers show us is where our arrow is at on our page. If I move it up and to the left, the numbers get smaller. Down to the right, they get larger. If I go up into this corner, we can see we're right near 0, 0. If I go in the margins, it becomes a negative number. So 0, 0 is our upper left hand margin. Since we already saw that we're in inches, if I come down to 1 inch down and 1 inch over, we see that we have just about 1 inch each way. If I wanted to make that a little more accurate, I would probably want to make my screen bigger. To do that, I would come down and change the view size by moving the scroll bar, or we can click the minus or the plus. I'm going to have to reposition my scroll bars to get me to that corner. But we can see our inch and inch makes it a little easier. These other numbers here have been remaining at 0. To get these numbers to change, we'll need to add something onto the screen. Let's add a rectangle. Clicking the rectangle, I'm going to start this at 1 and 1. I'm moving to the right about 2 inches and down about 1 inch. Now we can see what these numbers mean. We see that the shape is selected over on our left, and it is 2 inches wide by just under 1 inch long. And the upper left-hand corner starts in position 1, 1. This next little icon is telling us that we've updated the document and we have not saved it yet. If we had given this a name already, I would just double-click this and it would update the save. If I double-click this right now, it will give me the Save As dialog box, so I could give this document a name. If you don't see these tooltips, and you want to, we'd have to go into Tools, Options, General, and here's Tips. Clicking that on will turn on the tooltips, or turn them off if you find them irritating. Let's delete this box. To do that, we make sure that it's selected, meaning the little blue squares are around the outside, and hit the Delete key. To bring it back, we just click the Undo. Another way to select it is to just use our arrow select. And we can hit the delete key or we can use cut. And it's gone.